Hi, folks. I'm Jeff Altman of Pink Lady and Jeff Altman. And I'm here today to have you guys venture back into time, back into the disco era. The year was 1980. Things were going on. Richard Nixon was out of office. And our first show, Pink Lady and Jeff, which aired, I think, in 1980. And here's the first episode. It's got Sherman Helmsley in it, Burt Parks, and Blondie. And Blondie came to us by way of videotape. So put your finger down your throats when you see this one. It was as odd for me to be doing this show as if somebody had come down from the planet Zodar. I was working with two Japanese girls who we were told could speak English. And I remember walking into their dressing room and saying, "Girls, how's it going? How was your trip from Japan?" And they went, "It's good, Jeff." Enjoy.
Welcome to Pink Lady, starring Jeff Altman and Mie and Kei. With guest stars Blondie, Sherman Hemsley, and Burt Parks. And now, here he is, Jeff Altman.
Thank you. Thank you very, very much. This is amazing. I don't believe this. Here I am. I'm out here. Co-hosting a new show with Pink Lady, and it's amazing to me, really. I'm so excited. I'll tell you why. See, because it seems to me like just yesterday, in fact, it was yesterday, I was doing small clubs and maybe occasionally a talk show or something, and I guess the thing I regret is that I just wish my mom and dad could have been here tonight to share this moment with me, but they're next door in the Studio B watching Merv Griffin interview his suit. It is, though, really. Let me tell you, it is frightening coming out and hosting a new show. You know, you've got producers, directors, cameramen, crew coming up to you all day long, and they all ask the same question.
Pardon me, son, but who the hell are you?
Well, I'm not Pink Lady. I'm Jeff Altman. And even some of my friends say, they call me on the phone, they say, "Jeff, isn't this a strange way to make a living?" Well, I don't think so. You know, I really believe there's a little comedian in all of us. Here's mine.
Data height.
It is true. That's true. It really is true. There is a little comedian in all of us. Now, let me just take sort of a little survey here. How many of you have been out to dinner recently and wanted to try this silly little party gag? You bet. Anyway, tonight, ladies and gentlemen, you're about to see the American TV debut of Japan's biggest recording stars, Pink Lady. Now, when I say big, you're probably saying,
"Well, wait a minute, what's he talking about? Hey, hang on, wait a minute."
Trust me for a second. Just take a look at this film clip of one of their recent concerts in Japan. I had the tempura concession on that. Well, I think you can see now why I wanted to do a show with them. The girls are really special. And they've decided tonight to open the show with what I've been told is a traditional Japanese number. So, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mie and Kei, the wonderful Pink Lady.
Thank you. A traditional Japanese number?
You didn't like our song, Jeff?
Oh, no. I love the song. It's just that I didn't realize your honorable ancestors had boogie fever. Ladies and gentlemen, I should tell you at this point that this is me and this is Kei.
Right.
Now, you girls do speak English.
Oh, yes. We spent many, many hours in Japan learning. We wanted to speak perfect English when we got here.
Oh, and you speak English, too?
Yes. Do you?
Yes, I thought so, anyway. Kei, what I mean is, it's very difficult to learn to speak English properly.
Keep trying. You'll get better. Don't mind her. It takes Kei a while to get used to foreigners. But I like you already, Jeff. You are so, so handsome.
Oh, you just get turned on by my sexy round eyes.
Oh, brother. Even the dancing girls backstage were talking about you. What does it mean when they say you are a real hustler?
Real hustler. It means I'm a hustler. I do the dance. The hustle, a hustler.
Oh, that's hustler.
Hustler. A real hustler. What do you think?
Wonderful.
Listen, I know you girls are going to want to learn all about Hollywood while you're here, and so whatever you want to know, I'll teach you.
Oh, really?
Oh, sure.
Do you know any stars?
Any stars? Well, yes. So who do you want to meet?
How about Clint Eastwood?
Who else?
Charles Bronson?
Who else?
Paul Newman.
Who else you got? Look, I'll tell you what, girls, this could go on forever. I know Walter Cronkite, you know, the guy that does the new... Walter Cronkite. Good evening, this is Walter Cronkite. Well, in our top story tonight, after 20 seconds of grueling deliberation and an offer of over $86, semi-obscure comedian Jeff Altman today told NBC he'd do any show they wanted. That's the way it is.
Walter Cronkite!
Walter Cronkite! Walter Cronkite.
Never heard of him. Now you be nice to Jeff. He's going to teach us all about America. Besides, he's the cutest guy we've met since we got here.
You said that about a pilot, a customs man, a sky cab.
Now, wait a minute. どうしてみんがそんなたくさんの人好きだっていうの
言うでしょ
言ってません
言ってない
言ってました
言ってました
言ってました Hang on, girl. There's no point in getting an argument here, especially when I have no idea what you're talking about. I know how you feel. You're in a strange country here, and there's a lot of strange men around, and so from now on, it's just going to be the three of us.
No, four.
Four?
We have with us, Japanese we say, bodyguard.
What? Bodyguardo.
Mm-hmm. Bodyguardo.
Bodyguardo.
Bodyguard.
Bodyguard.
Uncle-san.
Whoa! Folks, this show could be tough.
Tonight on the show, we have our very special guest. Mr. Sherman Hemsley and Mr. Bart Parks.
And?
And our musical guest, Blondie.
Yeah, and... Right, and don't forget our good friend Body Gatto here, who later might swallow a Datsun.
And we're coming at you with all the boss sounds right here on your radio dial.
All right.
Turn up the music, the radio's playing and dance. Or look for the station that offers salvation. Maybe you need the chance.
Yes, yes, here I am, here I am. I'm here with you all today. Yes! All those who need to be healed of whatever may ail you, what's ever bothering you, come on down, because, yes, I can turn back the hands of time. You'd better believe I can, and I can make a ship sail on dry land. Hardy, hardy. Yes! Give me your hands, give me your hearts, give me your souls, and give me a small love offering. Anything you have, I take all credit cards. Anything at all, Mama. Yes! Come now, come down, everyone who needs to be healed. Oh, look at this poor child. What is your name and the town you're from? She has no idea. She cannot hear all the words. She is influenced by the terrible disco demon, possessed by the influence of AM and FM. But I shall make her hear all the words, child, by just laying hands on that sweet head. Yay! Come on home. Can you hear me, Mama? Say, baby.
Baby?
Yes, you've said it. Say, baby again.
Baby.
Yes, everybody say, baby.
Baby!
Yes, and she can still sing and dance. Yes. Sir, that's my...
Baby!
No, sir, I don't mean...
Baby!
Oh, yes, and I'd like to heal myself, too, of this hairdo. Woo! Come on home.
Here with an in-depth, on-the-spot interview with heavyweight contender Leonard Moon.
My name is Leonard Moon, and I don't have the brain of an ice cube.
Mr. Moon, what kind of sadistic and disgusting thrill do you receive from watching your opponent lying unconscious on the floor?
I don't know. I have never had that happen to me.
Mr. Moon, why then do you fight?
My father told me to, he wanted me to defend myself.
Against what?
Against my mother. She was a mean mother. She wore cleats on her slippers.
So that's it.
Fuzzy kind of slippers.
So that is it. You hate your mother. You probably hate all women like me.
No, you are a very pretty girl.
Oh?
Yeah.
That's interesting. You know, I've always had a thing about fighters. Ooh. Ooh.
Whoa. 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 Whoa.
So how about dinner?
No, I can't. I have promised Roy here I would take him to a salad bar. Don't you hit me now.
Ladies and gentlemen, you may have been wondering where your former president is. Tonight, Motor City Records goes in search of new talent, all the way to San Clemente, California, just back from a recent book-selling tour, now being featured with The Temptations. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hearts and hands together for Disco Dick Nixon and the Richard Nixon Soul Review.
Let me be very serendipity when I say, this song is available on tape. Everything I've ever done is available on tape. You know, I'm still younger than Ronald Reagan. One of these guys here, I'm sure, is Andrew Young. All right, fellas, let's hit it!
You said you were going to get some big name stars on the show.
Yes, so far, all we've seen is you.
All right, now, girls, listen, you got to trust me. I got calls into Brando, McQueen, Newman.
Jeff, yes. We got somebody.
You got somebody. Look, I appreciate what you're trying to do for me here, girls, but in order to get a big name star on the show, you've really got to know your way around the town.
We do. We got to map to the stars' homes.
They know who I am. Who are you?
Me? I'm Jeff Altman. How do you do?
Jeff Altman. Never heard of him.
Well, you see, I co-host this show.
Oh, how'd you get your own show?
I don't know. Letters I kept writing the network. Who knows?
Oh, Jeff, you're so funny.
Yes, the finest man we ever met.
Yeah, he's great.
Look, I know you girls are new in America, so if there's anything you need, don't hesitate to ask.
Well, wait a minute. Isn't that supposed to be my job?
Oh, thank you, Sherman.
So, ladies, any questions about this country?
Is it true that one day they are going to draft women in America?
I got two I could suggest.
Yeah, I heard they're going to draft women. They'll probably have their own USO shows, too, just like the men.
With a draft notice.
Well, that's better.
You know, the army isn't too bad, except the food is rotten. That's S-O-S.
Yes. Sushi on the shingle.
the 407-11th is proud to present the best friend the ladies in uniform ever had, Bobby Hope.
But I want to tell you, I'm Bobby Hope. And here we are at the first Army base for women. Or as they're known around the White House, Jimmy's Angels. But I want to tell you, here's the man you've all been waiting for. The winner of the Mr. Macho pageant. This man's got more moves than a congressman on the take. Joe Everton. Take a look at that beautiful hunk of talent.
You know, Bobby, I'm just doing my part.
Yeah, well, how about sending a few of those parts over here?
Well, that is somebody, Joe.
Well, you know, Bobby, I don't really consider it my body. It actually belongs to all of America. I'm just wearing it for you.
Hey, how about letting me try it on?
But I want to tell you, Joe, I understand that you are quite a catch, and I also know that you're unattached.
I think that rhymes, Bobby, but that's true, yes. I just haven't found Miss Wright yet.
Well, do you happen to see anyone in this audience that might fit that description?
Hey,
no! You want to know something, Bobby? All of them.
Come on, girls, we're in the Army now. Come on.
Come on, we got a show to put on here. Now for our next act, a little bit of nostalgia for you. Let's have a warm welcome for Sherman the Bod Hemsley. Come on out, Sherman.
She was the cutest little secretary you've ever seen. She made the bosses coffee and she kept the desk clean. One day she got a little bit more to do. Said the prayers that day to send the greetings to you. She's in the Army now, she is a sight to see. She's the boogie woogie bugle babe of Company B.
Well, girls, it's time to introduce our special guest star. Have you ever heard of Burt Parks?
Yes!
No.
Well, you've heard of the contest where they pick the most beautiful girl in the country?
Oh, yes! Miss Japan!
Well, almost. You see, Burt Parks hosted this country's version of that show, only they fired him.
That's awful.
I know. See, besides being so talented, Burt Parks is an American institution, kind of like a legend. But listen, he's coming out here in a minute. Let's kind of take it easy on him, okay? Between the three of us, I think he's heading for the last roundup, okay?
We understand.
Ladies and gentlemen, our very special guest star, Mr. Burt Parks.
Tell you something, I feel terrific.
Did you bring your horse?
Right, my horse?
Yes. He said you are heading for the last roundup.
You did, eh?
See, Bert, I didn't mean that.
Last roundup.
No, it was a joke.
A joke? I'll have you killed. Heading for the last roundup. Look, maybe you need a little rest, right?
Yeah, I feel a little tired.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah. I gotta tell you, I've just always loved your work, the way you look, the energy.
Thanks a lot. Look, kid.
You got it.
Get lost. Heading for the last roundup, is it? Okay, girls, what's next?
Why don't you introduce our cultural spot?
Your cultural spot?
Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time, here is Art Nouveau's Culture City.
This is Art Nouveau here for Art Nouveau's Culture City, the West's largest dealer in new and used objects of the arts. Hey, we're up to our armpits here in culture. We got paintings, old statues lying around here. We got new stuff, used stuff, and we want to pass it along to you. We want to give it to you. We got new stuff coming in direct from the Louvre in France, and we need to move this stuff out now. We got specials every week. I'm not a professional announcer. I don't claim to be a professional announcer. I'm strictly a businessman, a family man. I got kids. Hi, kids. How are you? Look at this. How about this? We got the Venus de Milo. Look at this. The factory made a small goof and gave her arms. Forget about it. We're gonna pass it on as a factory second and give you the savings, because that's what we do here, give you the savings. How about this over here? Look at this, Gainsburger's Blue Boy, huh? Gainsburg, you don't like it in blue? We got it in red, we got it in beige, we got it in aqua, we even got one in velvet. We got one in a Steelers uniform for the kids. A lot of the things that I wanted to do here is I wanted to bring culture and refinement to the young kids. That's why we're going to be showing you a documentary about Holland Perky, a mutual atona pause mild kingdom. You're going to love it. It shows you the animals and everything. The kids will love it. That's something, huh?
I love this word. Hello, my name is Holland Perky for mutual atona pause mild kingdom. In tonight's episode, you'll see me slap my assistant Jim into a sudden daze and then force him to see a screening of the movie 1941. Well, we'll go in search of John Belushi's career.
That's real culture, huh? I love kids. I love people. I'm a family man. I'm trying to do a living. Look at all this stuff. You, huh? See how blast been all. Bye, kids.
Ladies and gentlemen, the fabulous Blondie. continuing adventures of the Pink Falcon.
Falcon, this time you're not going to get away. Huh. There's nothing you can do that'll make me change my mind.
Not even this?
I don't know. That worked last time. What have you got for me, sweetheart?
How about a knuckle sandwich?
All right, you just stand back there. I know exactly what you're up to. You tied one end of this rope to the safe here. And your accomplice standing out there on the street is holding the other end, just waiting for your signal to pull this safe out the window. What do you have to say to that?
Okay, Mike.
That was Doc in the band. That was great, Doc. How about that suit he's got on? Something, huh? Glows in the dark. He got it at Three Mile Island Clothiers. But, we got a great show for you tonight. Bob Hope is here tonight to shamelessly plug his new special. Who else we got, Freddie? Good. We've got Judith Blagan of the Metropolitan Opera, worm orthodontist Carlton Budge, and these next two young ladies. They're the two biggest recording stars in Japan. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome two pretty young ladies, Pink Lady. Old joke, still good. Come on over and sit down. Come on. So good to have you here. Now, first of all, I'd like to welcome you girls here to America.
Thank you.
Now, let me see if I got this right. You're me and you're Kei.
That's right.
Now, let me ask you this question. Have you ever seen me before?
Yes. No.
You're new to this country. You mean you've never seen this show before?
Oh, yes. We've seen this show many, many times. We just never saw you before. When is Bill Cosby coming back?
Not soon, but we understand you girls brought a film clip of you on TV in Japan tonight.
It is one of the commercials we do.
Do you have commercials on this show?
Yes, we do. We sometimes even interrupt them for some entertainment. Anyway, we're gonna roll that. Bobby, roll that. Watch this in the studio monitors.
お控えなして、私ブーケの代わりのミー、ケイと申します。人呼んで、緊張マット。か、死んでくれる？
緊張マット。
ブーケの代わりよ。
That was great. I'm not sure what it was, but... Now, girls, I understand tonight that you brought along an actual Japanese stand-up comedian.
Yes, Shaki Nakamoto. We discovered him at the Comedy Pagoda.
At the Comedy Pagoda. Well, I hope you're all in a good mood tonight, folks. It's always nice to have a young, fresh, new comic on the show, especially when he's come over 6,000 miles. But here he is anyway. Welcome Japan's own Shaki Nakamoto.
Minasan konnichiwa. Iman, Nihon kara ton kita tokoro desu. Hontou ni ude ga sukarete shimaimashita. Oh, sui desu ne.
How hot was it?
Yeah, sukete. Tokori, sao, lemonade ni. Sugute, tabate tayo. Tabate tayo. Tabate tayo.
Dear mother, Kei and I have been in Hollywood for one whole week now. We hope everyone is well back in Japan. Tell them that Hollywood is not quite what we expected. Just yesterday, we went to the famous Schwab's drugstore.
Is this really Schwab's drugstore?
Yes, it is Schwab's drugstore. What will it be?
We just came here to become movie stars.
My dear young lady, every hour, on the hour, a young starlet comes here to be discovered. Hollywood isn't that way anymore. Listen to this. Now listen. Movies were movies when you paid a dime to escape. Cheering the hero and hissing the man in the cape. Romance and action and thrills. Oh, partner, there's gold in them hills. Movies were movies when after the title you know you got a happy ending. Swanson and Chaplin and Keaton and William S. Hart. No one pretending that what they were doing was art. They had some guts and some luck, but they were just making a buck. Movies were movies were movies when I was a kid. That's the way it is, my pretties. That's the way the world is today. Sometimes you're on top, and sometimes you're on the bottom.
Oh, we don't believe that.
You don't believe that?
Yeah.
Kissinger, what are you doing?
Well, Bert, I'm back here now trying to establish detente between myself and this mop.
As nervous as the night when I won my award for Cabernet. And the winner is absolutely thrilled, the truly divine James Honda.
Thank you. I'd like to say that this is an entertainment award, and to all of those people who changed it into a political event ought to be ashamed of themselves. This award is meaningful. Life is meaningful. Making the saint of the barrio was meaningful. This is not only my award, it belongs to all of the dedicated people who made this thing possible. I'd just like to say, this is my award. I am a zealous revolutionary, and I will save the world by becoming a star. See my movies. Buy my records. Hey!
Everybody, we're not talking about sports tonight. We're talking about an exclusive Hollywood premiere. We're standing here eagerly awaiting the arrival of starlet Jennifer Nova. As you know, last night she shot her first film. It was just returned from photomat this morning. Here we are at the premiere. Here she comes now, Jennifer Nova. Let's see if I can get a word with her. Hello, Jennifer.
Hi.
Careful, I'm allergic to those things. Let me ask you this, Jennifer. How does it feel to be called a Hollywood sex symbol?
Oh, Howard, why does everybody think of me as only a sex symbol?
I don't know, and I'm not sure that I care. Keep your hands off the rug. Beat it. Yes. Let me ask you this, Jennifer. What do you plan for your next upcoming film?
Oh, I'm going to do an intelligent, dramatic, and challenging role. I'm doing the remake of Mice and Men. I'm going to play mice.
A perfect casting job.
Thank you.
Yes. Jennifer, if this doesn't work out, maybe I can put something together for you with Leon Spinks.
Is he a producer?
I'm having trouble casting this crowd scene.
Send in the next crowd, please. Allison, your list of credits, Earthquake, Jaws, you're a crowd in Towering Inferno, and you're a crowd also in Tale of Two Cities.
That's right.
Very impressive.
Thank you.
Now, I am making a subway disaster movie. I'd like to do a scene. You're on the subway platform. You're a little impatient because the train is late. Good. Now, you look to your left, and you're shocked. The train is coming towards you. It is off the track, and you scream. You hit the deck. The danger has passed. You get up. You heave a sigh of relief. Good. Give me your resume and a picture. Don't call us. We'll call you.
I'm beginning to get the feeling that we're going to make a terrific team.
Don't bet on it.
Jeff, do you know Neil Diamond?
Neil Diamond was... Sure, he calls me all the time, always wants to hang out.
They will see at the party.
At the party?
See right here. We got the invitation to party at home of Mr. Neil Diamond.
Wow, Neil Diamond.
Yeah. Tell us, how do we get his house?
His house? Oh, well, you probably want to climb in your car, okay, and head out towards the valley.
But he's at the beach.
The beach. Well, you're going to need to make a U-turn out there in the valley, see, and come right back in there on the coast highway, and you stop when you get to Neil Diamond's house. Did you buy that?
See? And you said he wouldn't know how to get there.
Yeah. Say, did they, Did they say you could bring someone else along?
Oh, Jeff, we'd rather be with you.
Me too. We have a special treat for you now.
A treat?
Yeah, a concert for you and all the wonderful people who have made us feel so welcome here in America.
I feel better already.
And travel. Soon I will be there to pretend that even
right now, girls, this is definitely the end of the show. And I'd like to thank our fabulous guests, Blondie, Sherman Hemsley, and of course, Mr. Burt Parks. Of course, I'd also like to thank our comedy players, Jim Varney, Anna Mathias, Sherry Eichen, and of course, our very own peacock dancers. And now, I'd like to tell you something.
Wait, Jeff, we have one more surprise for you.
Surprise for me? No, girls. Now listen, please. I had the whole end of the show planned perfectly. You gotta learn to trust me.
We do trust you, Jeff. We have Japanese custom. At the end of the day, time to go into hot tub.
Time to go into hot tub? No, I don't go into hot tub. No, come on. Now, girls, no. Girls, I don't have a bathing suit on. I don't swim. I don't even float. I trip pretty well, but girls, this is silly because no. I don't care what you're gonna do. No. I don't care what you're gonna do or say. I absolutely will not go into a hot tub. When I was a little boy, I had a friend dangle me down a manhole cover. It was a sewer. I didn't like it then. I don't. It's just out of the question. Completely. No, girls. I am absolutely not. My skin cannot be.
Whoa.
No, I'm still. This is. Oh no. No, girls, my skin cannot be singed or seen. What are you doing? Oh, you girls are crazy. I mean, this suit cost me over $30. Come on, now, this is ridiculous. This is. This could be the start of a beautiful relationship. Oh, I like this. Oh.
Whoa!
I hope we've got some extra soap. Sayonara.
Good night!